I recently made a video about becoming a senior software engineer, because that's a question that I get a lot when I mentor junior developers. And even though I gave a lot of thought into producing that video, into creating that video, and trying to really summarize the main ideas, I left with the impression that something was missing. And the video has been out for quite some time now, but I kept on the back of my head this idea that there was something missing there. And just recently I saw this research that said that over 80% of software engineers have suffered from burnout. And then it clicked. Yes, that was the thing that I was worried about, that was spinning on the back of my head for so long, which is you have to take care of your mental health. Because the profession of being a software engineer, a coder, it has all of the main triggers that can cause a bad mental health state. It has this whole idea of you have to keep constantly studying, which can is in itself a trigger. It can come with the fear of missing out, or fear of lagging behind. It also has, as the profession, since it's a very new profession, it has a lot of esoteric and not really scientific methods and thinking about how to hire people. Do they have to know computer science or not? Not to mention that in many cases, the progression path in your career, how to go from a junior developer to a senior developer, is not well established, is not well written. So many people don't really know, especially if you're a junior developer, you don't really know what you need to do to become a senior developer. And when you see blog posts like you need to know functional programming, or you need to know all of these shiny new things happening, the unknown it also causes can cause a lot of anxiety. So, this is the video in itself. If you're starting a career as a software engineer, know for a fact that you have to take care of your mental health. If you are already in a state of suffering from burnout, do seek for professional help. I go to a therapist. It's been immensely helpful. And it's not going to be me, not a psychiatrist, talking on a YouTube video that's going to help you. Seek for professional help. But here are a few things that I learned from many years in the industry that might help you if you're beginning and not yet suffering from stress and burnout. So the first thing is, if you stay on the business long enough, if you stay in this industry long enough, you will eventually get to senior developer. To get promoted to a senior software engineer, of course you have to learn the technical details, but you do not necessarily have to be a ninja coder, you know, the one that knows every single detail about the programming language. It's about the impact that you have in your job. So I know many senior developers that they are not the person that knows absolutely everything about the programming language. I don't know absolutely everything about the programming language, about JavaScript. But they cause a positive impact in the company by being communicative, by mentor other junior developers, by assisting in code reviews. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that you should not study. What I'm trying to say is you don't need to learn to learn functional programming or design patterns or, you know, all of these things that people sell as things that real developers do. You don't need to know assembly. If you want to learn these things, they're going to be awesome and it's going to be helpful. But you can also learn them when needed. You don't need to hush it. I think what I'm trying to say is you don't have to stress over this. The second thing is there will always be a shiny new thing. And just as a matter of probability, it's most likely that we will not be working in your tech stack using the next shiny new thing. And if you do, 6 months from now, while we're still working on that project, a new shiny new thing will appear. So you have to learn how to deal with the fear of missing out. If you don't have it, great. If you do have it, you have to try. You have to figure out a way to live with it, because we're never going to always be working on greenfield projects and shiny new technologies. And here's the thing, there's a lot of knowledge that you get to acquire from working on any kind of project in software engineer. Many of these knowledge is portable. It doesn't matter if you're working on an Ember project. It's an amazing framework. Even if you work with Backbone, so to speak, which is technology from 10 years ago, there's a lot of knowledge to be acquired there. You're going to learn tons of JavaScript, and these are all portable to when you're going to get in a React project or in a Vue project or some other more modern framework. So know that learning and working on any tech stack will add to your knowledge and to your career. It doesn't really need to be the new shiny thing always. Another one is you don't have to be, if you don't feel like doing a side project, if you don't feel passionate about having to the burning desire to code at all times, it's absolutely fine. I go through phases. Sometimes I have a burst of energy and I do want to do a lot of side projects and do an open source library. Sometimes I just want to stop working and go to bed, you know? And that's absolutely fine. And you don't have to be one or another or fluctuate between the different shades. There are software engineers that do all sorts of things and they're pretty competent and in their jobs. There's no pattern that you have to follow to be considered a good software engineer. Just be yourself and don't feel the pressure to be something that you are not. Don't feel pressured to have a side project or to learn a different language or to whatever. These things, they will be good for you, for your learning. But do them when you can, when you feel like, not because you feel pressured to do so. And I feel like overall, learn how to say no. I feel like lots of software engineers and developers think that they don't have a say when, say, you have a really big crunch time and they feel like there's nothing that can be done unless put their heads down and just work until they're dying. You don't have to do that. You can absolutely say no. In many situations, when you say no, but come with a plan, when you say no, say we can't do it this way, but we're never going to meet this deadline with all of these features, but here is a plan. We can do A, B, and C, and then launch D a week after. Learn how to say no and propose different things, but don't just do whatever gets imposed into you if that is bad for you and for your health. And if the company just says no to you, maybe it's a good idea to just start looking for a different job. I know it's very entitled to me, and I say this in a position of lots of privilege, but when it comes to your health, that might be the best thing to do. That's all I had to say. Sorry, this is not about React or JavaScript, but I felt that I was missing saying that, and this is an important thing to be said by someone. All right, see you in the next one.